everyone, my name is Iris France, 我叫林婉如. Today we're going to talk about review preference. And just for your reference, I am using Hal Varian Intermediate Microeconomics book, and review preference is in chapter 6. So before we talk about details, I want to give you the big idea about what review preference means. So an economist will not ask you what you prefer, but rather an economist will observe your behavior. So I'm going to start with an analogy. I want you to go back to your high school senior year when you're going out to the prom. And suppose two boys, Alex and Bob, they both ask you out as their date to a prom night. But of course, you can only go out with one of them. Now, suppose you end up going out with Alex. Then an economist will say that you prefer Alex to Bob. Now, suppose there's another boy. His name is Charlie. And he is not available at the prom night because, say, he is at a birthday party with his mom. So he is not available. So we can't tell whether you prefer Alex to Charlie or Charlie to Alex because Charlie is not available anyway. It could be that you don't care so much about Charlie and he is not available, so that's irrelevant. Or it could be that you really like to go out with Charlie, but he's just not available. And therefore, we can't tell whether you prefer Alex to Charlie or Charlie to Alex because Charlie is not available. However, we know both Alex and Bob were available. They both want you to go out with them, but you end up choosing Alex. That means you prefer Alex to Bob. Now, let's go back to our example in our textbook. So we have a budget line and we have good one and good two. So we have three bundles. Bundle X has a X1 amount of good one and X2 amount of good two. Bundle Y has a Y1 amount of good one, Y2 amount of good two. And bundle Z has a Z1 amount of good one and Z2 amount of good two. Now, you can see on your budget line, bundle X stands on the budget line and bundle Y is within the budget line. And suppose you end up choosing bundle X, then we say that bundle X is revealed preferred to bundle Y because they're both available. Y is affordable, but you end up not choosing Y, you're choosing X. And how about bundle Z? Well, bundle Z is outside of the budget line, so you cannot afford it. So that's out of the question. And therefore, you cannot tell whether you prefer X to Z or Z to X. However, you know that you do prefer X to Y because Y is available, but you're not choosing it. So you can see our bundle X is like Alex. Our bundle Y is like Bob. Our bundle Z is like Charlie. So you can see that's what review preference means. And I hope this helps. I'll see you next time.